So these are the items I usually carry in my go bag. First of all, let's start with my go bag. I prefer a bag that is comfortable for me to carry, that holds and can support enough weight in it, and also that has lots of pockets, because that's actually going to help me to divide my contents by categories. So speaking about categories, let's start with having entertainment, having a book that I can, you know, use to write things, notebooks, cards, also pens, pencils. I also carry money. It's important to have cash with you. Don't tell anyone how much cash you have. Also important documentation. Why? You never know when you're gonna need it. Maybe you need to claim insurance. Maybe you just need to get help. So having personal documentation is very important as well. Now let's go with having a blanket, having extra clothes, maybe having an extra pair of shoes. Shoes that you know they're gonna be comfortable for you to maybe standing for long periods of time. If you go to a shelter, maybe you wanna have flip-flops. Think of the weather conditions, think of the things that you're gonna need. Also, let's go now with personal hygiene. You know, you don't need a lot. And there are various ways for you to find these items. So make sure that what you have is, again, what you're gonna be needing for at least 72 hours. You also need a first aid kit. Maybe you have already these items in your home, so you can just gather them and put it in a Ziploc bag. I like to use Ziploc bags because it helps me to quickly identify my items instead of having to go all the way through my backpack. I have a secret mask. You know, just go through everything you have and make sure that you have the right contents in them. Also, let's go now to our personal safety. I like to have mask, gloves, also a poncho in case it rains, a mosquito head net. At least I'm from the Caribbean, and yes, we have lots of mosquitoes. So that for me is the most. Also, again, work gloves. You have a survival rescue blanket that you can use to warm yourself and protect from the environment, a hat, you know, if you have to stand long times in lines waiting and maybe you are having direct sun exposure, that's something to also, it's also good to have. Now let's go with food and water. I always like to have multiple types of water collection. I have my life straw. I also have a bag here that I can just collect water and have it for me. Maybe I need to take a quick shower, water for drinking, my utensils that I can clean very quickly. You can also look plastic utensils, some of those that we constantly gather and accumulate in our houses. You have food. Maybe you can also look for bars, things that you know you're gonna eat. So that's a good thing to have and that are gonna last enough time. Now moving along, I have my communication items and other general safety items. I love to have a mini survival kit. Some of the things I have here, like multi-purpose tools, I have quite a few of them around, running around my backpack, but you know, you can find this anywhere. Also, I have glow sticks for communication or just lighting. If you need some ropes, safety vest, mirrors, of course, it's very important having a radio. And if you have a cell phone, make sure that your external battery has been charged. You may need that. And extra batteries, you know, make sure that you actually carry the type of batteries you are gonna need based on the equipment you have in your go bag. So these are just some of the items I have, or at least most of the items I have in my go bag. You can go into the website and check out some of the most known lists. And again, make sure that you are aware of your plan A, B, C, and also worst case scenarios when you're planning and making your own go bag.